is another beautiful day for the realities of life program by your own presenter Sajjad, and I say welcome to tonight's program, the realities of life by your own presenter Sajjad. Stay tuned. Real issues, real people, topical facts as it affects the environment. Join your own presenter, Sajjad, as he brings you your exposure, the facts of life, everywhere, from your best online, AYO Radio, broadcasting live in UK and Nigeria. At www.ayoradio.uk.com. It's nothing but the facts of life.
Real talk, real issues, real people, topical facts as it affects the environment. Join your own presenter, Sajjad, as he brings to your exposure the facts of life, everywhere, from your best online, AYO Radio,
broadcasting live in UK and Nigeria at www.ayoradio.uk.com. It's nothing but a fact of life.
Oh yes, it's nothing but a fact of life. And then I want us to bring our minds to the drawing board. Yes, we need to go back to the drawing board and then see how we can definitely trace our steps from where we've gotten it from. And that is why I'll play you this song from Maroon 5. Yes, Maroon 5, where we talked about bringing back the memories. Stay tuned, the reality of life is still on. We'll get the topic started after this song from Maroon 5. And it's called this Memories. Memories bring back. We need to bring back the memory. We need to go back to the drawing board and then definitely talk about the issues that are really something, things that are definitely going wrong. Yes, and today, like I said, we shall be talking on parenthood responsibility. Parenthood responsibility. How can we talk about the training of our children nowadays? As you know that most of our children are not properly trained at the moment, and that is why we can smell an abnormal future of our nation, of our society, of our church. Yes, what is the fate of the existence of tomorrow's church? What is the fate of the existence of tribes, the church, religious institutes, the community, the nation? How can we definitely have, what do we call it? How can we have a good leadership in a nation? We need to talk about that.
Bobby!
Sajjan speaking in Yoruba, right? Yes, sorry for those that are calling the line at the moment. I think we can say Sajjan Bishop because I'm not talking on today's topic. So,
I just come to say Sajjan is not see your face, so I had not
We need to exercise patience for the calling now until I talk on today's topic before you can start contributing your own. Thank you so much. Now, talking about education, can a nation exist without education? Certainly not. A human, an individual, can certainly not exist without being imparted into. The reason is this. Even the animals also pass through education. Now, let me let you know this, that as human, if when you were a child, you were giving birth, no one think of taking care of you, training you on these sort of things. You were just giving birth, the mother didn't breastfeed you, you know, everything. And then you grew up to a youth. You will be like a mook even when you are not insane. Because you wouldn't know anything to do. Like, nothing to do. You will just be amazed at seeing people. Even you might not even exist. You might not even live to a youthful age because nobody is there to guide you or to put you through. So, in one way or the other, education is always into our lives, either by going to the school, church, home, or anywhere. But our lives before the Nigerian
wish this.
Yes, as a parent, who do we refer to as a parent? A parent is a person who acts as rearing a child or children. That is who we can refer to as a parent. Now, I want to let you know this, that parents are not only referred to as the biological parents. We have biological parents and we have the adoptive parents. In any area that you find yourself, you are a parent. Now, if we are talking about parents being a person rearing a child or children, definitely in one way or the other, we all play the role of parenthood. Are you with me? Because Yoruba people say when someone gives birth to a child, both the community and the parents are responsible in training that child. So you can see that we all have the responsibility of imparting into other people's life.
Now I want to let you know this, that
when we now talk about responsibility. Responsibility can now be referred to as a duty or an obligation. So we all as an individual, we have the responsibility to impart into other people's life. Especially today we are talking about parenthood responsibility. Before we can now move to the education, parenthood responsibility. Now, it is amazing that some parents don't really understand their duty as a parent. And I will definitely expose that to you. Either you are a parent or you are someone who is a parent that you are to tell them that, hey, these are your responsibility. Are you with me? My dear viewers and listeners of the Realities of Life radio program, AYU Radio at Ikorodu, Nigeria, also in UK, London. As a parent, you have the responsibility, the duty to take care of your child or children properly. Are you with me? Yes. You are to cater for your child or children properly. No, notwithstanding of any circumstances that you find yourself, you own the responsibility of catering for your children. That is first. Now, second is that you have the responsibility of providing shelter, clothing, and education to your children. Are you with me? Of life radio program, you don't have any excuse not to cater for your children or your child. If you are telling me that you have 10
Hello? All right, can hear you now. All right, the reality of life is still on. I think keep on trying. We are having some network issues here. And then when it is sorted out, we'll definitely get it. We all own the responsibility of caring for our children, whether you are an adoptive parent or a biological parent. Are you with me? Now, you have the responsibility of providing the food, shelter, and clothing of your children. And that is why sometimes I laugh at some parents when they are having marriage issue. And then you see the mothers moving to one corner, the father going to one corner. Hey, you are putting those children or that child in the middle. And later in the future, both of you belong to suffer for it. You see, so no matter the marital issue that both of you have, you must not transfer that to your children because they are innocent of it. I have some people who are passing through that situation at the moment. And sometimes I try and weep for them. Because some parents don't actually understand the implication of what they are actually doing. It is sad. So as a parent, know it to yourself that whether you are a mother or a father, you own the responsibility of providing for that child. If that man leaves the home and leaves that child with you, you own the responsibility of providing for that child. If that woman leaves the home, leaves the child with you, you own the responsibility of providing for that child. Because if you do not provide for them, someone outside will definitely provide for them. And then you will not be recognized as their parents anymore. Even they might be provided for, or they might be provided for erroneously. And once it is done, then you tell me you are already poisoning the society with bad youth. My dear viewers of the Realities of Life radio program, we are talking on the parenthood responsibility. How can our parents actually exhibit their responsibility? How can they actually understand their responsibility as a parent? Now, I want to expose you to another thing. The causes of irresponsible parenting in our society. Yes, we have some causes that are responsible to the irresponsible parenthood of our society. Yes, and first of all,
go down the road.
Not my suggestion. Now, first we have lack of love among couples. I've said that before. As a male, as a female, if you do not love yourself, if that unity doesn't exist any longer between you, between the both of you, it will definitely affect the children or the child. There's no two ways about it. It will definitely affect them. And that's why you need to try as much as possible to think of whatever thing you do, the repercussion will be on those children because they are under your umbrella of the Realities of Life radio program, I am Samson, your own presenter. Now, the second is the cause of irresponsible parenting in our society. Take note of that. Friends, I talked about lack of love among couples.
Now the second year is lack of knowledge about family planning or family management.
Hey, of course it's rampant.
You are going to be a family person and then you do not understand how to manage our home. Tell me, you are going to rush in and definitely rush out because you do not have the knowledge about what you are going into. So it is very important as youth, and this is why youth of nowadays who are thinking of going to be married, try to understand what it means to be a father or a mother. It is very important. If not, all right. Now the third one here is early marriage. Are you with me? Early marriage. Most of our youth of nowadays, in fact, some parents contribute to the early marriage that we have in the society of today, which is very saddening. It is very bad. You don't put your children into what they are just understand. Someone that doesn't even understand what it takes to be a youth, and then you are exposing the person to be a married person. No, it's very bad. So please ensure you put in your children step by step before you can go into marriage. It is very important. The step is when they are child, from child to youth, and then you allow them to achieve what they ought to achieve being a youth before you can put them into marriage. And no, notice this, everything is not all about going to school. Are you with me? It is not all about going to school. It is all about the parental training. Yes, the parental training. It is very there is issue between you and your husband or your wife, then you neglect the children. If you are neglecting them, then you are allowing them to be nurtured by the society. And you know what I'm talking about, society nurturing the children. There are implications to that, either good or bad. But hey, one of the bad is what we can talk about here, and when you talk about street nurturing for your children. So please, it's very important. We are talking on the cause of irresponsible parenthood. We also have lack of family planning among couples. That's why I said it before that as parents, you need to plan, you need to understand what you are going into. And when you are going into a marriage, plan for yourself. If you are earning 20,000 naira, plan with your 20,000 naira. And don't just believe that something good will work out, something miracle will work out from where? From manna
or from heaven. I don't know. So you need to plan for yourself. You and your wife or your husband, plan for yourself. It is very important. When you are able to plan for yourself, then things will definitely go right with you and your family. But when you don't plan for yourself, there is things going wrong, going confusedly because you fail to plan for yourself. I think if we're talking about, things going wrong or going confusedly, it's not talk about wedlock. When you see a child being impregnated unexpectedly and then she's being married unexpectedly. By that, the male is just confused, confounded. The female is also confounded. But when you are taking a decision that you want to marry or you want to get into marriage, then you think of how to plan for that marriage, how to put things in place. You'll see how the reality of life radio program. And after the 30 minutes, we'll be going on a break. We'll be taking a breather, which is a break, to talk about some other things that you should know about that we can definitely take. Keep AYO Radio ongoing, the reality of life ongoing, and of course, that will definitely promote you. The reality of life is still on. The last one I have there with me is insufficient finance. You are earning 5,000 naira and you want to go and get married. Don't you see that as foolishness? Eh? Yes, now. You are earning 5,000 naira. Okay, you are earning 10,000 naira in this world of nowadays. It is the nature of the country Nigeria and you want to go and get married. When you get married, won't you give birth? Or you want to get married and then remain celibacy? No, answer me. You're going into marriage, you need to think of your finance. Finance sufficiency. That is even still better. There are some couples that the husband doesn't even do anything. What he does is go to the bus and then he collects 20 naira. And then the wife goes to the street and then says, Paraga, tell me, how can such family build up a standard family? How? So you need to talk to yourself, plan for yourself, and then think wisely before you think of going to marriage. Now, as a female, when the person is coming, come calling your hand in marriage, look at what that person does. What do you do? The man says, don't worry, God will provide. That's irony. You're deluding yourself. Eh? You're deceiving yourself. God will provide what? The grace of God is already sufficient for you. Why can't you make use of it? So don't just have that mindset. When we get married, things will definitely work out fine. What if it doesn't work out fine? Ask that man. What if it doesn't work out fine? What happens? Am I going to live or will this be a past tense marriage? Certainly not. So you need to think of finance sufficiency before going into any marriage. With that, you'll be able to plan for yourself. When the money is not there, how can you plan for a family without finance? Certainly, there's no way that such can happen.
bringing back the memory and then looking back to the drawing board to see where we definitely, where we are actually getting it from here, the realities of life still on. We're just trying to get things sorted out here so that we can get our call coming in. Now my question for today, before I bring in the remedy, is who should be more responsible in catering for the children? Is it the mother or the father? You can start calling in on the number at 080-86-73-1034. 080-86-73-1034. Some of you can see DJ Ali posted it online here. Yeah, you can call in and then your call will definitely be received now. And let us know who should be more responsible in catering for the children. Is it the parents? I mean the mother or the father? As a parent, both of you must learn to attend marriage seminar. In fact, before being a couple, you should attend marriage seminar so that you can be knowledgeable about what you are going into. And then you ask yourself the question, can I actually go into this marriage or I should just remain single forever like Sir James? Certainly not, I'm not ready to do that. But you should go into marriage seminar so that you would be able to understand what it takes to be a father or a mother. So going to marriage seminar, that is the first one. And the second one is proper family planning. As a couple, when you think of being married to each other, plan for yourself. Take book and pen, sit down, something and say, okay, how do you want to plan our things? Okay, this is how we plan. So we are going to have a joint account, we'll do this and we'll do that. Between this time and this time, we should be able to achieve this and do that. How do you want to go about it? Your wife, do you want to work? Do you want to be doing a business woman? Things like that. You plan for your family. It is very important. So that is the second one. And then the third one is closeness among parents and offspring. As parents, you must try as much as possible to be close to your children. No matter the time you come back from work. Yeah, we believe that some persons come home very late, but try as much as possible to be close to your parents and to your children is very important. Try as much as possible to be close to your children so as to know their wants and needs. And that is your opportunity for the fourth one today, which is identifying and providing children's needs.
Some parents don't even try to identify to identify their children's needs. Then tell me, how can you now know their needs and provide for it for them? And if you cannot try to identify their needs, then you might not be able to have a good future of child in that your family. And if you are doing that, it will definitely bounce back at you. Because what you fail to correct them of, it will bounce back at you by using it against you in the future. And when it happens, you start saying, hey, this and that, so you start blaming. Would you blame the children or who are you to blame? You say, okay, because they have grown up with, they have grown up being. No, because you have failed to correct them when they were still very fresh. And the last one I have there with me is finance sufficiency. Try as much as possible to be sufficient in your finance as a male, especially. If you are earning 10,000 naira, think it twice before you go into that marriage. Think of the society, think of the environment. Can 10,000 naira actually cater for your family for some period of time? Even if you have it in mind that your salary might be increased of any period, think of that starting period. What if it doesn't increase? Are you with me? This is how I'll be rounding up the first segment before we go to the second segment of today's program, which is education, parenthood responsibility. Before I go, let me name this again, that you must try to be close to your children, provide for them, try to identify and provide for their basic needs, and then be finance sufficient. The reality of life.